In this video, I'm going to show you a template that is up in our website, and I want to demonstrate how it is being built on the back end to give you an idea. Hi, Nanika here, and I design WordPress membership sites. Now, if you have watched my previous videos, this is still very similar to how I build the templates for WordPress membership sites. So I'm using custom post type, meta fields, and of course, for this one, we're using LearnDash. Now, the difference between those templates that I previously built, this time I have built this template using Gutenberg with the help of Cadence Blocks. So I'm going to show you how is the back end is set up to give you an idea. If you have any specific question, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer that. And if you're interested to purchase this template, this is also available in our website. Now, the things that I've built here are already covered in my previous videos. So if you want to dive more deeply in each of this, I highly suggest you check out those videos, such as how to create a query using like a my course list using JetEngine and use that to display and hide content. So that's one of the main thing that I'm using in this specific template. So as you can see, I am logged in using my test account here. And if the user is not enrolled to a LearnDash, and this is the LearnDash main course page. So if the user is not enrolled to the LearnDash, it's going to have different views. So it's going to have different button and you can customize where that button will go. And there's going to be a different section about this course, a video, and then a button. That button here and this button will point to the same page. And then if we scroll down below, you can also see that we still have the course content and we can expand that. And then there's more items on the sidebar. Now, if they are enrolled, it's going to look different. So if they're enrolled, they're going to see a different button that says start course. And that will point to the first lesson of this course. And you can see that we now have the course and the materials visible with the progress bar from LearnDash. So this is like the content if they are already enrolled to the LearnDash course. And still we have the course content and the sidebar items. So I'm gonna give you idea how this looks on the back end. Okay, so as an admin, let's go to the back end side. And the first thing that I'm going to show you is the elements. So in the elements, this is the course template. So you can see that just like with Elementor, we can create a single post template here using Gutenberg with the help of Cadence theme and blocks. So we have the dynamic content. So they have this one dynamic. I'm actually using a combination of dynamic content from Cadence. And if we go to our navigator here, I also have a dynamic term from JetEngine in here. You just can't see it because it doesn't have a fallback set. But it is showing a course categories. Now, I do have two buttons here. So if you purchase this template, you can customize the color of this button easily depending on your branding. But you can see that I have a button for those who are enrolled, and there is a dynamic visibility set up. And this is using the query that show this element if they have this item, which is the current post my courses query that we built. Again, we've already covered that in the past video, so please check out that tutorial. It's exactly similar query that I built for this one. And then if they're not enrolled, again, we also show this. So in this case, it says query has not items. So it's just a vice versa. And then we have some meta fields here. As you can see, it is using the icon list from Cadence Blocks. And then these numbers are dynamic. It's pulling a value from a custom field. And then we have first, this row is for those who are enrolled. So this is the post content that you have seen. If they're not enrolled, then they're going to see different content. And again, we're still using the My Courses query in here. And then we have the title. Again, this is a meta fields that I've set, and then a video. So we kind of created a template for that section. And then here, we're using a shortcode course content to display that course content table. And then we have some design on the sidebar. Now let's go to our query just to show you how that looks. So in the query builder, so I have the My Courses. And this is the current setup. So I have an SQL query, LearnDash user activity. Activity type is equal to access. User ID is equal to current ID. Course ID is equal to current ID. So that's the rule that I have set in here. Now, Cadence also allows you to assign different navigation. So I have two header here. If they are logged in, it's showing a different items. And if they're not logged in, it's also going to show a different items above. So we have some cart in here. And then we have a button to the sign up and then log in page. Now, if I edit this course, at the bottom part, there is a LearnDash additional course content meta box that we created. So we added a cover photo, which is being used on this background. And then we have the start course URL, number of lessons, number of topics, number of quiz. Now, if they don't have access to the course, we are showing a specific headline, specific content, a video, and a no access button. So that is being controlled in here. Now, the great thing about Cadence that I noticed is at first I needed to adjust how it looks because compared to Elementor, the experience for the like page builder is a bit kind of like there's a bit of a learning curve when building it. But once you start building your template, it's gonna be super easy from what I noticed. Though there's a bit of a glitch that I noticed when pulling the list of blocks in here. But that's easily fixable if you reload the page or try to click, like try to add a plus directly rather than in here. And also the different thing with Cadence is they have all of the, like once you click one thing, all of the settings is on the right side with different options. And then there's also different options here. So the first is the block settings, and then there's also element settings, and then there's Cadence blocks control. So this page also scored A with 99% performance under G2 metrics. So in comparison to Elementor, building your pages or templates under Gutenberg is actually like blazing fast. That's the first thing that I noticed compared to Elementor. So in the coming videos, I'm actually gonna test more, especially with BuddyBoss, because BuddyBoss itself is a very heavy theme with the plugins itself. So I'm actually looking at testing more Gutenberg build with BuddyBoss. So stay tuned for that upcoming videos. But you can see that in this template, it is very fast. Now, I do admit that there are some things that I find a bit difficult in terms of styling some elements in Gutenberg compared to Elementor. But again, I don't think that's really a big problem. I usually just be able to fix that with a simple line of CSS code, which you can easily insert in your page excerpt, like in here. But there are some sections, especially this dynamic items from JetEngine, but the dynamic items from Cadence block, because they also have theirs, are easily customizable. So yeah, that's it for this video. I just want to share this template. Again, if you're interested, it is available in our website. since this is an early bird version, we're going to keep on improving this template and add those pages that we commonly build when setting up WordPress membership sites. So if you have any requests or suggestions for this specific template, please send us a message through our website and we'll hear your feedback and see if we could implement that to improve more this template. I'm also gonna release next the Elementor version of the Duolingo inspired template. So stay tuned on this, on that one. That should be released very soon next week. I also wanna share that other than Elementor, we're also encouraging you to try out Gutenberg to set up your templates because I can see that it is gonna be a big chunk of improvement in terms of performance. So I hope this video helps and you have learned something from it. Now, if you're still feeling stuck on how to create and manage your WordPress membership site, visit us at wpmembershipdesigns.com where you can learn how we can help with your projects. And you may also book a call to determine if we are the right fit for your needs. Again, thanks for watching this video. If you have any question regarding this, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer your question as soon as I could, or else create a separate video tutorial regarding that. That's it for this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.